Oh my gosh, bro. Oh my god. I'm talking to the YouTube real quick. You know what I'm saying? Oh my gosh. I know y'all. I know. Y'all haven't seen me in a minute. I know, man. I'm so sorry. I want to say absolutely sorry to everyone out there. Because I know how it feels for somebody to go and then leave with unexpectedly without saying anything. You feel me? And then come back. Like, everything just all good. Like, you just left. Like, didn't you just leave? And didn't say nothing to nobody? Like, bro, come on, bro. I'm so sorry, y'all. As you can see by the title, it's going to say, let me explain myself. So, this video ain't going to be too long. I'm just here to let y'all know. I can tell I just woke up and stuff like that. So, hold on. Give me a second. You ready? Hold on. Okay. I'm back. Y'all see it? Yeah, y'all see it. Like, I see it too. Y'all see it. Yeah. But anyways, where I left off at, I was basically talking about how, like, I was gonna explain myself on what was going on and why I was gone for so long. So one of the things is first of all, getting my life together with my girlfriend. As you can, I ain't gonna see. Hold on, just a second. One second, I tell y'all that's the last part. That's the last part because it's the last thing we did. So, one of the reasons why I disappeared is because, financial situations and just living situations. It got real hard. I'm not even gonna lie to you. It got real hard for the both of us. Cause her being my girlfriend and me being her boyfriend and stuff like that, I wasn't going to let her be homeless or anything like that because she did get kicked out of her mom's house and stuff like that. So I dared take her in. Well, my brother, first it was my dad's place. It was my dad's place. I'm not going to lie to you. Then we couldn't stay there because me and my dad had got into an argument, which was real crazy. And it was a big argument. I'm not going to lie. But hopefully me and him do get back on good terms one day, because honestly, hopefully we do become friends, because I don't see me and him being father and son. I don't really see that. I'm going to be honest with y'all. I don't really see anything like that, but it's life. It happens. You know what I'm saying? You can't bring back the past or anything like that. So that's why I try not to talk about the past too much. Because you can't bring it back. So what's the point of talking about it? But we stayed with him. Got into an argument, everything like that. I would go into detail on why. Like detail on why we moved in with him in the first place. But it's too much to talk about. And I'm trying to make this video short. So we moved in with him. I got a job. She got to end up getting a job at Chick-fil-A. I got a job at Buffalo Wild Wings. It was cool at first. Everything like that. He started bugging us and stuff like that. It was just too much. You feel me? I'm like, bro, if you want us to move out, just let me know. Like, if you really want me to move out and her to move out, just let me know. Like, it ain't that big of a problem. Because at the end of the day, if you feel some type of way, let me know. You'll speak to me. Come with respect. You feel me? Now go come with respect. So we all got into an argument that night. But one thing about it is, Miss Faye, my stepmom, we love you, girl. We love you.
Love you,
Miss Faye. Yeah, you hear that? We love you, Miss Faye. Because she's a really supportive person. I'm not even gonna lie to you, bro. I only been knowing her for a few months, bro. And she has supported me more than my father has. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. I'm gonna keep it a buck. But I mean, it is what it is. You got people out there like that. That's gonna support you like that. Just because they see who you are. And where you're trying to go and the things you're trying to get done, they're going to love you for who you are. You feel me? But on to the next. So we end up getting an argument that night, end up moving out that night, text my brother. Oh, yo, can my girl come over and spend the night and stuff like that? Because such happened, blah, blah, blah. Sure. So I stay and stuff like that. Second night, we wasn't too sure, so we ended up sleeping in the car that night. That was the crazy part. We slept in the car that night, and he seen us that morning. He knocked on the window. He told us to go in the house. So from there on, it was like, 2021, that was like a 2021 November, around November. And we've been staying with him since, March. We've been staying with him since March 11th, because that is the day, as y'all see, we got our own place. Let me show you. Matter of fact, let me explain, because I don't want to take too long. I'll show y'all when I'm done, okay? When I'm done, I'll show y'all. You feel me? But anyways, we've been staying with him since. But on December 25th, I know what day that is. December 25th is Christmas. I'll be telling y'all about my car and everything like that before Christmas and everything, before all that. But on December 25th is the day that my car broke down on the interstate. I'll never forget that day. On the interstate, we broke down. But the reason why we broke down is because of my fault. I should listen to my girlfriend. Males, if your girlfriend refer to you something or say something to you, listen, bro. I'm not going to lie to you, bro. You got to listen, bro. Because most of the time, they're right. Don't get me wrong. We don't want to listen sometimes because we're males. We do that. Hold on. I'm not gonna die. I'm an OG. But anyways, like I was saying, if your female refer you to something or say something to you, explaining it and saying, oh, this should be do this or should do that, listen sometimes, bro. We don't want to listen all the time, but listen sometimes, bro. Because most of the time, they're right, bro. I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm gonna be real with you. I didn't listen, and therefore,
it cost us $3,000.
It cost us $2,000. I mean, it was hard to get, though. It was really hard to get. But we got it. We got it done. Now I've just been holding myself responsible to maintain my car maintenance. But, like I was saying, the reason why my car broke down is because I didn't put no oil in it. And then, because I was doing Uber Eats consistently and stuff like that, I didn't put no oil in it. So, therefore, my car didn't let me know that I needed oil, but it was giving me signs from the engine that it needed oil, and I didn't know any type of signs. So, therefore, when I did get it checked out, it was already too late. I tried every method in a book to get it work, to get the oil back in the car and make it work. But once you hear that knocking noise, guys, it's over with. Your engine's blown, bro. Unless you know somebody that could get in there and fix all that, but after that, bro, your engine's blown, bro. Don't even try. Just get a new engine, bro. But as you can see, guys, that did happen. My car did break down, which I'm not too mad about. I was upset, but I'm not too mad about, because at the end of the day, I'm gonna get things done, whether if I got a car or not, because I've been doing it before. So that happened. What else happened in that short time span? We just really been working, staying home with my brother. And I really appreciate my brother for letting us come over there and stay, bro. It was like a big blessing. Well, I've been staying with my brother for like 5-6 years now. And that is a big blessing after he took me in, after we got evicted out of my mom's place. And I just... Hold on, y'all. Anyways, like I was saying, after that happened, I've just been staying with my brother for the past few years, bro. He has been a great, great, great dad towards me, even though he's not my dad. He's my older brother. He has been a great person, great sibling. He's cool, bro. Like, just cool, bro. Like, cool, cool. You know how to be like, that's my cool big bro. You know what I mean? That's my brother. Yeah, that's my brother. But anyways, bro, I got a whole bunch of other brothers, and I love them to death at the end of the day. There's no different type of love for each other. One love for all y'all niggas. You know, one love for all y'all. I don't want to say that on YouTube because I don't want to get banned. But anyways, let me stop talking and go back what I was saying. You know what I mean? But anyways, like I was saying, got evicted, lived my brother for 6 years. We've been staying with him for like 4 or 5 months now. I'm not gonna hold you. We told him to go get our own place. It's hard to look for a place down in St. Pete. I'm not going to lie to you. If you live in Florida, it's going to be hard. Unless you live up north, like north. You know what I mean? But we eventually found a place. Rent kind of up there. But, you know, as long as we both maintaining our jobs and working our butts off and getting what we want, we should be straight, bro. I was supposed to tell y'all that last, but like, I'm gonna show y'all that place last. But anyways, as you guys can see, I'm back. I thought I'd never go say that, huh? But I am back. I'm back for good. And now that I got my own place and I feel comfortable doing things, it is on. She's getting pranked. Anybody come over, they're getting pranked. Regardless of the situation, you're gonna get pranked. You come over to my place, you're getting pranked. I don't care what you're saying. I don't care what you're doing. But anyways, y'all, let me show y'all a place. Well, the room, huh? This is the living room. You know, we got some incense lit. That's my gaming section. We still got to put some stuff up, you know what I mean? Yeah, I put this bicycles over there. The kitchen's right over here, you know what I mean? We got a little food pantry. So if you're willing to send us something to help us out with, you know what I'm saying, our living situation, you know what I'm saying, just, you know, send us something, you feel me? I don't got no P.O. box or anything like that. I don't got no big fans or anything like that. But the house isn't bad. The place isn't bad. The environment, it's been okay so far. I haven't really seen or heard anything or gotten into anything with anybody because it's my, third day in here. So, I mean, I would show y'all the room, but it's kind of messy right now because we're doing a lot of stuff. Because it's her birthday. It's her birthday, guys.
It's my birthday.
It's her birthday. We're about to go do some stuff. And I would vlog it, but y'all see, I'm getting straight to the point of what I'm trying to tell y'all. And I'm going to go from there. So this is going to be it until further notice. Y'all comment down below on what y'all want to see. Please comment down below on what y'all want to see. Because anything y'all post, I promise you, I would do it, bro. I'll try to do it. Promise, though, I will try to do it. It ain't guaranteed, but I will try to do it. But y'all stay tuned, man. At the end of the day, I'm glad I'm back. And I'm glad y'all are here to listen, whoever watching this video. I'm glad y'all here to watch this video, because if y'all can watch this video, y'all go get an understanding of what I've been gone for so long. But anyways, y'all stay tuned. Like I always say, take 5 seconds out of y'all, give it time to like, comment, and subscribe. It's your boy Marc Dark, and smash that like button, because you already know I gotta start saying that. Y'all gotta smash that like button. But anyways, y'all, it's your boy Marc Dark. Y'all stay tuned. Yes sir, I love y'all. Y'all stay healthy, y'all stay blessed, gang.